Not quite sure if it will be better now. So far it hasn't dropped any frames, so it should be better. Okay, that's the audio level. So that's not that important in this way. Okay, so it looks better. Looks more stable. I'm not dropping any frames, so let's continue. And sorry about that. Let's go back to this. And back in here. So, what was I doing here? Oh yeah, I wanted to figure out this. So, we need the orientation in here. So that's not zero, and this is. And now we need to first check for if it's not zero. Then we do this, and then we do something else here. Then we check if it is the. Orientation, and we do something else, and if it's not, then we do this again. And if it is the case, then we are not using that. But same transform, and we take this one. And I think I need to convert that to be pure. Because I don't want to put it in there. So, for here. Yeah, okay, it's just using that. So it should compile. Didn't do anything. That's not good. Okay, that didn't work. Why did that not work? Probably because the angles here are different. Yeah, we are using the wrong. Let's try this here. Maybe that works. Yes, it works. There we go. We can set. Can set doors here. Yoo-hoo. Awesome. And I also need to be able to set them. Yeah, for the towers, I might need to set more than one door. Which brings me to the same problem I had before. So I kind of need to do this differently. Why is that south? That's strange. It shouldn't be south. Should be east. Yeah, it's because I need to go in here and fix those values. So south. plus 180. But it needs to be minus 90, so it needs to be 2. Okay. This needs to be 270. This needs to be 315. This needs to be 0. 45. And here we have 225, 180. And 90. Now we have that there, but it doesn't fix our problem. But we can do something back here. For this, we can we can get the new start location here. because this would be in here, which means I need to change this slightly. Let's break all these. Link. Then here we are making a vector. Take these and this. And when this is a door, then we are setting our new start location. And when this is completed, turn note, okay, and then we are doing that. Let's compile. And in our tower mesh, we are getting this. Oh, yeah, I need to fix the offset here. I don't know why.
ones that, I mean. So, in here. And we have that. Set. Yeah, that's a problem. I think the offset is right. Yeah, the offset is right, but no, it's not right. We're not offsetting anything here, so we need to do the offset there inside our set gate. We need to do the offset. This thing that's coming in here, we need to offset already. And depending on the offset, we are also getting a different vector to this, which means we need a different function here to get the offset. Think we need this. Let's see. Get our start location. That's the point we have there. Then we are adding the wall lengths. It basically doing this. But we need to figure out where we are doing that. So and yeah, we don't need this. It's our start location. And we need this -2. And then we need to do this after that. Even though this is not the right offset, it's the right offset, but the how I apply it here is different depending on the orientation. Yep. And now the gate is in the right spot. But like I said, it's only working depending on orientation, I think. Yeah. So if we take this wall element and change this to southeast, and then we change the rotation of the second one to southwest. Yeah, then we, yeah, it's screwed. So we basically need function to figure out, depending on our orientation, what kind of offset do we need? I think. So that we only need to multiply that by half the length of our attached object, our next object, basically. Why is this not offset correctly? I think it is. So no, it isn't. Let's see, we have the
It's not working. So basically, always need the new location. And then orientation of the next object. Yeah, there's another problem with this idea. That's why I think spline would be the better solution, even though it's not really working for us. And we would be able to extremely frustrating because I can't wrap my head around that. I mean, I have one small victory here, but I just need to do more in that. Let's try to get the other values here. Okay, we have the, we're getting the angle from our orientation. That's awesome. But we also need to get the location from the orientation, basically. Or at least we need to get this for the next piece, and then deep, I see another problem. So if we go for set wall pieces, we are adding that. And depending on location, on orientation, we should be subtracting or adding, kind of. So it depends on the orientation here as well. So what do we need for this? We basically need a vector. We also need to get a vector from the orientation, and then we can multiply that. Okay, let's see. For this, else was. Okay, north is minus y. So south is plus y. East is plus is plus x, and west is minus x. So northeast would be one here, minus one here. This would be one, one. Minus one. One, and this would be minus one, minus one. And this would be pure. So we are taking our take this start location here. And then we want to multiply that by our orientation. Vector. No, we need to take our orientation vector, multiply that with this here, to get the offset location, I think. Yep. Let's take that. That's the offset location. And I think we add that to our location here, so we don't need to break this. No, I don't think that's right. Yeah, we need to subtract this and then feed it in here. That's our start location, and then we need to add those. Get our new start location. Let's try that. Okay, that's complete bollocks. And I think I know why. Because there's an offset in here that we haven't calculated into this. Okay, so now it's aligned properly, I hope. But the next starting location is not right because this is not in the right spot yet. So for the all pieces, to get the angle. And we also need to do the same as we did for the gate here. Getting the vector. And then we need to do a bit of mass here. So we need the length multiplied by our number of volts. That's correct. And then we need to multiply that take our start location. Right. Because we also need to make an offset here. Yeah, this again. And then we multiply that, and I think we add that to this. and then feed it into the location here. And in the end, we are doing this. And location. Even though that's not right. Yeah, no, that's not right. This is okay. We take the start location and we do this, but that's here. That's the thing that's not okay, because we take the start location, then we need to divide this by 2. Not quite sure if that's right, but maybe it works. Let's see what we get. Oh, yeah, no. Definitely no. I'm trying to construct one big wall, just with offsets of starting locations, and basically what I did here by hand with single pieces, I want to do in one big piece, just with offsets. But so far it doesn't work. And I just saw something that's kind of wrong here, so we need to multiply this by 'Feed it in here.' So the first one would be at the start location, the second one would get the offset, basically. Let's see if that works. Even though this is wrong. It should be the start location. I think it's the orientation that's the problem here. Let's put this to south. Yeah, no. Yeah, it's not what we need there. We also don't need this. We need the starting location. Okay, we need this. The offset is wrong here. Is it? All right, because now we are not offsetting that as at all. Wait, let's try something. When we take the start location into here, what happens? Okay, the start location is wrong. So our gate gives us a wrong start location. Let's see if we set this to north. This to north. To north, do we get? Oh, we still get the wrong offset there. The other thing is that I am using the same meshes for all these towers, walls and stuff like that, and I want to optimize this into one big mesh so that I save a few draw calls. But I'm not sure if it's worth the effort at the moment. Because I just can't figure it out. And another thing is,
I want to have walkways here, functional walkways, and at the moment I have walls and stuff like that. So it's, I would either need to completely build this by hand or figure out a system that yes, they use the same texture but offset by they are using a texture atlas. So I think they use the same material. Let me see. Yeah, most of them use the same material here. So, yeah, okay, the draw calls might not be that much of a problem. They are assets that I bought in the Unity asset store. And ported them over to Unreal. So I think the best solution for my problem would be building this all by hand. It's time consuming, but I have the most control over it. Even though, no, that doesn't work. Damn. Yeah, I think I need to change my tower. At least need to change the tower so that I have some kind of option in here to set doors on specific floor, on specific floors. Yeah, the problem is it doesn't work for the towers because I already had problems with coordinates here, and the walls are extremely screwed up in their positioning. So
I think I just need to change my tower script, tower blueprint here, so that I can specify different doorways on it. Maybe set a number of doorways and where they are, because I already have this. This part is something that I could port over. Here where I'm using this. No, that would be the same problem as I had here. So doing it in a 3D program doesn't help in that way, in that regard. So as you can see here, I'm setting the wall pieces by using cosinus, and then also a radius that I calculated here, which doesn't work with all of them. So what I can do for this wall is for this tower, I can specify the amount of walls it has in here, so I can play around with that. And to pick the right amount and the right setup for that, I didn't like square towers, and I was experimenting with different solutions for that. And I thought that using octagonal towers would look better. But I also wanted to connect pieces to them properly, but yeah. Yeah, there's always one thing that's not working correctly. And it will get even harder when I'm trying to figure out the interior. Because I need to figure out the floors and then kind of either set a different mesh for each floor, and then need to know which of these have an opening so that I need to set a floor, because you can walk into this and then
what other interior objects do I need here? So it's an absolute mess. Yes, that's the solution I will go with, probably. Creating different floor pieces and then just setting them here. Depending on what the number of walls is, I'm setting the different floor piece. Because maybe I want to have octagonal towers here, and if I go over here to the brewery, maybe I want to have different number of walls here. Maybe I want hexagonal towers here. So that would be also something I can think about. But I just wanted to try out to make the system here, but it doesn't really seem to work. I think I can make it work for the towers alone, so that I can specify different spots on the tower where doorways would be, and then which floors we need to render as a result. No, which floors need to have meshes, stuff like that. But not the continuous building I have here. Yeah. Game dev is hard sometimes. And I think I will stop here. And I will be back on Monday with more of this. And back on Sunday with more Witcher 3. Hopefully this works out. Even though there's someone coming over over the weekend. Family stuff. Birthdays and stuff like that. But I think I still can manage to stream on Sunday. Shouldn't be too much to do for me there.
And then I need to change the... I think I'm changing the towers so that I can specify different ways where you can get in. So that I can finally put my guards to complete wall duty. So they are patrolling along the walls here. Because at the moment they're just running in a circle. In here. And it would be awesome if I could have them running around on top here. Along the walls. Okay. But like I said, I will stop though and be back later. Bye bye.